my crafty friends, it's Crystal with Happy to Plan. I'm going to be doing my Plan With Me video for the week of January 28th through the 3rd of February. And I am going to be using one more kit that I bought at the expo. So if you watched my last two Plan With Me videos, they are basically kits that I bought at the expo. I really have been inspired by them, so I wanted to go ahead and use this last one. So this one is called Flea Market. Let me grab it, actually. So this is what it is. So this one came from the Photoplay company, and it's called French Flea Market. What I decided that I was going to use was this one page. It's got a really pretty floral pattern on the back. But I thought this was really cute. It's really sweet. It kind of has like a tea, vintage Paris kind of theme to it. So I'm going to kind of play off that Paris theme. I have the die cut set that came with the pack, and I'll be using some pieces out of here. So I'm going to go ahead and just jump right in and get started. So I wanted to go ahead and do something a little bit different. I've done this before in one of my other planner spreads a while ago, and I wanted to kind of recreate it and make it a little bit different. So what I decided to do was I'm cutting up boxes to fit the strip down below. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make kind of like banner flag, page flags out of it. And then I'm actually going to be layering it. So there's going to be double the page flags, but you'll see here in a second what I'm talking about. And then I did want to make sure that when I cut the paper, I cut the designs out the way that I wanted them. So the specific designs that I wanted. And then you'll see I'm cutting a little bit of a banner cut here, little flag banner cut. And then I use that as a template for the other one. And then I'm going to go ahead and do that again for the top line. So yeah, I'm going to put those two there. And then I'm just going to get another piece here and cut it out. And again, I tried to make sure that I kind of used a different, so I didn't want to use like that Hello Gorgeous again in, I didn't want to say it twice. Not that it would have mattered because I ultimately covered that part up anyway, but I didn't know that at the time. So I just wanted to make sure that I had a different design at the bottom of that. So I'm just, again, using that as a template and cutting that as a little flaggy, little page flag thing. And wanted to include that chair, so I just cut it to make sure that I included the chair, little chair image in that one. All right, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put these on the four corners. Now, when I did this, I didn't like how it looked. I felt like it looked a little bit weird. So you can see here, I'm trying to kind of figure out what I wanna do. And then I ultimately decided that I want it to be like that instead. So I did decide that I wanted to go ahead and double it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the back of that page, has this really cool, like almost kind of like a wallpaper pattern. And I cut out another page flag in the same exact template. So I use my little template there and cut it out. And then I'm gonna flip it onto the back so that it's actually on double-sided. So you can see there it kind of pokes out the side. And then I'm deciding on doing that on the other one. Now, and I put this together. I didn't show you all of these because it was going to be boring just showing you a bunch of me cutting these little flags up. So I will be moving on to another thing here in a second. But when I was cutting them up and I got this all laid out, I really didn't like the fact that it had all of that same pattern on it. You can see there, that's kind of why I flipped those two pieces over. So I decided to pull another page. This page actually was one of the pages that I wanted to use my journaling card because of the back of the page. But this page had the same little flowers as it does on the other page that says Hello Gorgeous. So I decided to pull a couple of pieces of that in just to kind of mix up the pattern a little bit. And then I was really happy with it. I thought it looked good. And so I just used the little piece of scrap there to cover the side panel piece. And I did a little bit of layering. And then I took some of the die cuts and just kind of laid them out where I wanted them to be placed. And then I'm ultimately going to place them during sticker time. So you'll see that here in a second. But that is one way that I like to use the die cuts. I like to kind of pre-plan where I'm going to put them. So I have an idea of like where my functional stickers are going to go and things like that. Okay, you can kind of see I'm just kind of messing around with the design, trying to make sure that I have it where I wanted it, because that piece of paper, the little rose piece of paper, was not as long as the side panel piece. So I had to kind of cover up the fact that it was not as long as that piece. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get the side panel cut up to fit into that area. And then what I decided to do was I wanted to kind of just make it a little bit more vintage looking. So I'm going to grab my distressed ink here, and I'm going to look here because it's on my table. It's called Black Soot, and it's from Tim Holtz. And I'm just going to go ahead and ink up all of these pieces, and I don't show you all of it, so don't worry. I'm just showing you a couple pieces, but I just grabbed my little distress tool, stampy tool thing, and then just inked up all the edges. And by the magic of editing, it's all done. There you go. And then I definitely wanted to cover up the bottom piece. I did not like that with this layout. So I grabbed some little lace washi tape stuff that I got at Daiso Japan. And I'm just going to go ahead and put that on the bottom on both sides. It does hang off the bottom a little bit, but I kind of like that. So I made it hang off the bottom a little bit. And then once I get that down, I'm going to go ahead and get everything glued down using my glue stick or my glue tape, glue dots, tape and adhesive roller here that I always use. And what I did was I kind of just, like you could see, I kind of offset them a little bit. And then I'm just going to do that for all four of them and then get those glued down. And again, not going to show you all that because that's just boring. So you can see that I made sure I had it everything, and then it was all done. Now it's going to be sticker time! Alright, as I've said before, I typically plan as I go, so it's more kind of a memory keeping book than an actual planner, but I did have a couple things that I wanted to make sure that I wrote down. So I want to keep track of my daily devotionals, and I do have a lunch that I'm going to on Monday, and I have my game night that used to be on Tuesdays, and now we're on Thursdays. So I used a couple of the kit stickers from one of the Mambi kits to just write out game night and then put 7 p.m. And then I also have a study that I'm going to on Saturdays. So I just wrote a note there as well. All right. Oh, and then I wrote also that I'm going to be trying to start my little golden book journals that I've been working on. I've got some of them done, but need to continue working on that. All right. And I do want to let you know I did add a couple more stickers kind of at the end of the process of getting all of those functional stickers on. And I meant to record that, but I didn't record it. But you will see it at the very end. All right, so I'm going to work on my journal card and just took that piece of paper that we were using before. It was the little bit of scrap that was left. And I had another little piece of scrap, and I wanted to use these little stickers that came in the kit. They say, I'm going to open my book and look at what they say because I don't remember. It says, love this, always, grace, style, beauty. So those are what the little things say. And it's kind of cute because they were little flags and it looked like they were wrapping around the pole or the little piece of paper. So I just glued those on. And then I'm going to take that little bingo card that says Paris, and I'm just going to put some paper behind it just to make it pop off the page a little bit. This is just a scrap piece of paper that I had. And I'm also going to ink that up as well. You can see there I'm kind of tearing the page, so I'm just kind of tearing it to fit just a little bit bigger than that Paris little bingo card. And I just inked up all of the edges, and then I took one of the stickers from the sticker sheet. It says vintagey and fabulous. So I thought that was cute. Hence the reason why I named this thing vintagey and fabulous. So I'm just going to get that all glued down. Use some Fabri-Tac glue from Beacon. And there is my journal card. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and get it into my planner. Come on. There we go. All right, so I did want to show you that I am taking the picture of a day. So I've been doing that the whole year. So almost done with the month of January, and I've almost got my whole month done. So wish me luck that I continue to do my picture of the day. All right, so there is the first page, and you can see there I've added a couple flower stickers and that label sticker, and I added a couple stickers on this side as well. So that is it. I hope that you guys enjoyed this Plan With Me video. I really do love doing this, and I hope that you guys like it. Please leave me a comment down below letting me know what part is your favorite part of this planner, Plan With Me. All right, and make sure you subscribe for more videos. See you next time. Bye.